Good afternoon, welcome back to my channel. Today is a Sunday, typically we spend Sundays with our families, so today I want to talk about families. I saw this post on Reddit, someone, it's actually an art student, was complaining about his unsupportive family members, his parents. He said it's just a few months to his graduation, he needs to finish this portfolio, otherwise he wouldn't be able to graduate and all the things he had been working for will be like ruined. But every time he comes home, he sees his parents and his parents will tell him, you're not good enough, you'll never make it as an artist, it will ruin your lives, you'll never be successful as an artist. And he just felt very broken inside and he had this crisis and he couldn't get himself together to produce this portfolio so that he could graduate and go out there to prove himself to the world. When I saw this post, I felt very sad because I know this is something really real. Most of you who are choosing art as a career might face this situation. Even if you choose another alternative career that is not a typical 9-to-5 job, you might face this like unsupported family members, friends or mentors or whoever that is close to you means a lot to you. And I think when you come to this situation of this student who are about to graduate from an art school and the parents were not supportive, it's too late. The best is to get them on board with your idea of pursuing your dreams at the very beginning of it. So you have to train them like, did you see the movie How to Train Your Dragon? Yes, you have to train your family and friends like Train Your Dragons. You have to expose this idea to them like at early on. You're like, when you were like very young, if you say, oh, I always want to become a dancer or artist or a performer, and perhaps the moment at 18 you choose this career, they'll say, oh, right, it's not a rush of blood to your head. It makes sense because you always wanted to do this. And in this case, they might be more supportive, at least more understandable when it comes to seeing you making this very radical, different choice from anyone else. The second thing you need to do is to come up with a plan. Because becoming an artist is like having your own business in art. You need a business plan, or at least a career plan. Something that shows that you are ready, you are prepared, and you have everything under control. You have plan A, plan B, plan C, and what if the first one fails, then you carry out the second one. You have everything studied and under control. And this will create confidence. They see that you have everything under control, and you can achieve it with your own power, and perhaps they will agree with your choices. And the third thing is to get someone's approval. This one is really tricky, but this is a really, really interesting sales technique. Get someone who is already successful in this field, perhaps art professor or maybe established artist, or maybe a senior like a remote family member who has some expertise in this industry, to get them say one thing. He will become a great artist, don't worry. I mean, she will do great. She has whatever it takes to become a successful artist. Just to get them to say this so that your parents or your family member have this, you know, external approval or let's say confidence and trust to say that, okay, your future will be great. Because all what they want is a great future for you and also not to ruin your life so that you come back home crying, right? If you don't know anyone who is established or who can do this favor for you, make sure you go online and look for some kind of competition or like, you know, enter a competition in a school and make sure you win certain kind of competition so you can come home and you say, look, I have won this competition, I'm gonna do great, you know, I'm the best. It shows that you just need someone or something to prove that it's not just you dreaming about your future, your future actually exists out there for you to get it. Last but not the least, you have to make sure that you can stand and pay for the consequences of what is to come after this choice. It's to be able to be liable for your choices of pursuing this career. Imagine if you borrow a car and you crash it. You can't pay for the reparation, you come back to your parents, you borrow money. And guess what? The second time you want to borrow a car, rent a car, buy a car, your parents will say, don't do that, you'll crash the car. You see, if you are able to be liable of your consequences, that is crashed car, if you have the money to fix it, then you know who is them to judge your choices. So you just make sure you save enough money, perhaps you have a certain kind of plan, what if it doesn't work for you, and perhaps you can always go back to a 9-to-5 job, or you can prove that you have sufficient fund to support yourself yourself and you can risk it and you're not putting anyone else at stake or at risk. Because having this career, having this dream, it is your choice. Nobody else should pay for your choice. No matter how much they love you, how close they are to you, whatever bond they have with you, it is your choice, it is your life, it is your dreams to chase. So make sure that you are liable, you're responsible for it, and you can afford no matter the success or the failure. Okay, that's all what I want to say today. I hope you'll never come across the situation of unsupported family members or friends, but I wish the best for your convincing anyone who come across your way. That's all what I want to say for today. Thank you very much for watching. See you in the next video.